In Beijing, on the morning of June 2, 2001, after some 32 hours in buses, airports, and planes, choir members saw their first relics of ancient China. But they were worried. All was not right. Half the choir had not made it to China. A huge mix-up, missed flights, passport and visa snarls, became a daunting distraction to what was supposed to be an exciting first day and first concert in China.
49 of us are here in Beijing. The remaining 27 are in the air. The problem was that we had their passports. The fact that we did not come in as a group also messed up our group visa.
It sounds like a lot of red tape.
It's a lot of red tape.
Didn't want to turn around.
Choir member Susanna Pace ended up in the Beijing airport with no passport.
I was nervous, scary, didn't know what was going to happen.
After long negotiations with Chinese customs, she got in, but only for one day, until her passport showed up with the second group.
If you don't get it, what happens? What do you have to do today?
Probably go back home.
After one day?
Yes. So I'm having as much fun as I can.
I'll cry if you have to leave.
They said if it did not arrive on this afternoon's flight, she would be deported, and the student would be deported who did not have a passport.
And what about you?
I would go with her.
They didn't know if Chinese customs would allow the two to stay while their colleagues arrived.
So we will meet them at 2 o'clock at the airport, and I will never be happier in my life to see a group of people than I will that group. I am so ready to be all together.
While awaiting their colleagues' arrival, they sat down to the first of many Chinese meals and the awkward task of eating with chopsticks.
Okay, I predict that these three lose at least 10 pounds before we get back, just because they can't get the food.
I really enjoyed the first few meals, and I was proud of myself for trying all the different dishes, because I'm sometimes kind of a picky eater over here.
They took some comfort in eating what appeared to be Chinese French fries with ketchup.
What'd they say that this is?
Snake wine.
Snake wine?
But they were amazed at a Chinese delicacy called snake wine. As they pondered why anyone would enjoy wine with a snake in it, they awaited their colleagues who were still en route. The singer without her passport said goodbye to friends, just in case. Their Chinese tour guides told them everything would work out just fine. But still, they were very apprehensive as they left the group. 6 hours later, reunion. Without their luggage for over 2 days, the choir members left behind received toiletries and white t-shirts from the airline. The t-shirts quickly became a way of expressing their frustration.
I love the way you marked out planes.
Now, after the hassles and red tape of their separation, the concert tour could begin. The Americans' first taste of Chinese music was at a university in Beijing.
Americans don't often say it's a pity.
Before and after the concert, the Americans and Chinese visited. These face-to-face conversations being a major motivation for the tour in the first place. Kelly Dame wanted her West Plains, Missouri singers to have personal experiences with their Beijing counterparts.
We have foreign language we can take too, but we only have Spanish, German, and French.
American Chinese.
They pretty much just wanted to know like what we learned in school and I mean, stuff we take for granted is what they wanted to know. What we had for lunch, they ask us what we ate at lunch on a daily basis. They ask what we did in our spare time, just after school, before school, you know, what our school hours were.
He's having a bath.
He's having a bath.
Mm-hmm.
they always wanted to practice their English, and of course none of us spoke Chinese, so we were happy to allow them to do that.
We've only been in China for 6 hours.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
The university concert hall filled with Chinese music students and others wanting to hear and meet the American choir. By now, the choir had been reunited only a couple of hours. Many were exhausted. Their luggage elsewhere. They couldn't dress in tuxedos and gowns as they had planned, but they decided to go ahead and perform in t-shirts. Audience at this Beijing concert consisted of Chinese music students eager to hear their American counterparts. Information about life outside China is controlled by the government. Although Chinese now enjoy more individual liberties than back in the days of Chairman Mao, first-hand knowledge about Americans is not easy to experience. In the coming 2 weeks, the choir would learn how tightly the Chinese government controls freedoms Americans take for granted. But for this day, the exhausted choir's first concert was a success, and the tour was at last underway.